It was the year 1898. Swamiji was recouping his health at Darjeeling when he received the news of an outbreak of plague in Calcutta. 3/4 of the population had left the metropolis owing to the plague epidemic. Hearing this news, Swamiji said,
"We have to serve them, even though we are required to sell everything. We were only wandering monks living under a tree. We shall stay under a tree."
On May the 3rd, the Swami reached Calcutta, although his health was not good. He thought that he might be of help to his people. They were terror-stricken by the plague and dismayed by the plague regulations. It was as if a storm were about to burst over Calcutta. People were fleeing in panic. Troops were called to quell riots. The Swami grasped the gravity of the situation at once. On the day of his arrival at the mutt, he drafted a plague manifesto in Bengali and in Hindi. He wanted to start relief operations immediately to help the afflicted.
"Swamiji, where will the funds come from?"
"Why? We shall sell the newly bought mutt grounds if necessary. We are sannyasis. We must be ready to sleep under the trees and live on daily bhiksha as we did before. What? Should we care for mutt and possessions when by disposing of them we could relieve thousands suffering before our eyes?"
Fortunately, this extreme step was not necessary, for he soon received promises of ample funds for his immediate work. He instructed them to teach sanitation and to themselves clean the lanes and houses of the areas to which they were sent. The relief that this service afforded the plague patients was immense, and the measures adopted by the Swami gave the people confidence. The work endeared him to them. They saw that he was in truth a practical Vedantin, for he applied the metaphysical doctrines of the Vedanta to the relief of want and affliction among his fellow men.
"This is the gist of all worship, to be pure and to do good to others. He who sees Shiva in the poor, in the weak and in the diseased really worships Shiva, and if he sees Shiva only in the image, his worship is but preliminary. He who has served and helped one poor man seeing Shiva in him, without thinking of his caste or creed or race or anything, with him Shiva is more pleased than with a man who sees him only in temples. This life is short. The vanities of the world are transient. But they alone live who live for others. The rest are more dead than alive. Doing good to others out of compassion is good, but the seva of all beings in the spirit of the Lord is better."